So the attention now turns to the track and the 4x400 metre relay heats for men. And the home team represented in this first heat, Great Britain. But the Belgians, very strong indeed. Dierenink, Borle, that's Jonathan Borle, Antoine Guillet and Kevin Borle. So that's a very strong Belgian team indeed, with the two Borles going very, very well indeed at the moment. There are the records, 255.39, that's an astonishing record in fact, that 255, very, very quick, very quick. So there's the lineup for you. Lane 2, Trinidad and Tobago, 3 Great Britain, 4 Belgium, 5 South Africa, 6 Cuba, 7 Kenya, 8 Germany, 9 Poland. Right on the inside, Trinidad and Tobago. Alon Gordon, who got the bronze in the 400 metres, gets them underway. Their national record was set with a team slightly different. René Quao was involved in that team. He's not here. Nigel Levine, semi-finalist in the 400 metres, leads off the British 4x4 with William Conrad Williams. Jack Green, who fell in the hurdles. Martin Rooney will anchor them. Then the Belgians, Dierenink. They were fourth in the World Championships in 2009 and fifth last year. Dierenink, Borle, Jonathan, Antoine Gillet and Kevin Borle to bring them home. The South Africans, De Jager, Motswani, and then Oscar Pistorius will run, the Blade Runner, which the semi-final before, and De Beer will anchor them in. And the Cuban, William Colazo, Rey de la Sierra, Orsés Rodriguez and Omar Cisneros. Just missed the 400 metre hurdles final at Cisneros. Now there's the Kenyan quartet, Horesa, Kilu, Machera and Kishien. World Junior semi-finalist in the 400 metres is their anchor runner. The Germans, eighth in the last two World Championships, third in the European Championships this year. Klaas, Garber, Kruger and Schneider. And the Poles have always got a good reputation. It's pretty well the team that set their season's best, but Jan Ciepela is missing from this. And Michael Piotrczak is the man to replace him. He'll run the third leg. First three plus two. So, this should be very competitive indeed. There are two heats. Trinidad Tobago, Great Britain, Belgium, South Africa, Cuba, Kenya, Germany, Poland. Heat one of the men's 4x400 metres relay. The first three and the two fastest losers from two heats go through to the final. It's a very wide and difficult stagger actually on the 4x4 because the second runner has to run in bends all the way around the first bend and then in the back straight they will break into the inside lane. But this first leg, Cuba going very strongly at the moment, so Germany right on the outside chasing the Poles down. It'll unwind, it's a big stagger this, South Africa not going quite so well, and Levine, Trinidad and Tobago right on the inside going okay, and Great Britain struggling a little bit at the moment with Nigel Levine. He's got a lot of work to do now, but there is a big stagger and that will catch up a little bit, very deceptive. So, Trinidad and Tobago may well be the team to take over first, even though it's pretty even all round, but they run that next bend in lanes, and all of a sudden Conrad Williams goes for the home team, and in the back straight they will break for the inside, and that will be important. Trinidad and Tobago lead, Great Britain in second place, Cuba in third, Poland in fourth, Kenya in fifth, South Africa sixth, Germany seventh, and Belgium in lane in eighth place. But the Belgians will make some ground now. So the number two athletes running for is Jared Solomon for Trinidad and Tobago, and for Great Britain is Conrad Williams. And there's a foot. Kenya and South Africa have got... Oh, no, it's not Kenya, is it? Yes, it is. It's Kenya and South Africa have fallen. Now then, Trinidad and Tobago leading, Cuba second, Great Britain third, and this is the Jack Green, who fell in the 400-metre hurdles, didn't manage to get into his running, and we're just looking down now at the South African team, which will not progress any further, and that makes it easier, with the Kenyans gone as well. So, Cuba lead, Trinidad and Tobago in second place, Great Britain and Jack Green in third. And there's a lot of work to do now. The Poles are coming through into fourth place ahead of Belgium, with Germany at the back of this, but with the first three to come through, a good run by Green, very good run by Jack Green of Great Britain. And this is going to be Martin Rooney who takes the baton, and Great Britain going to the lead now. Another athlete bites the dust, but Great Britain leading.
Outstanding run by Jack Green, 44-4.
Yeah, that's very, very quick. He looked good, didn't he? He's fresh. And so Martin Rooney taking the British team. Cuba in second place, Trinidad and Tobago in third, and these three look as though they're going to go through. There's nothing that the Borlés can do on this occasion. Kevin Borlé is quick, but not that quick. He is going to attack. He's coming around the bend, just off your shot now, but there's a lot of ground to make up. Rooney for Great Britain, so it's Great Britain looking for a good lane in the final. Trinidad Tobago coming into second place. Great Britain win. Trinidad Tobago second. Cuba third. Belgium fourth. Poland fifth. Germany sixth. 3:00:38 for Great Britain. And that is a season's best for them. It's a slightly different team than the one that competed in the European Championships. And Peter, you, as we see the Kenyans coming in, but that was a great shame. I'm not quite sure what happened there. I was watching the teams at the front. Did you notice what happened?
I can't show exactly. I thought they had over each other, but I'm not sure exactly. We'll probably get a replay. But a fine run. Jack Green, 44-4. And Martin Rooney coming home in 44-9. Devine actually had a pretty useful first leg, 45-5, because he was behind Gordon of Trinidad, who was possibly under 45 seconds there, and Williams a 45-5 second leg. So a very fine run by the British squad, Rooney easing down a little bit, and of course Trinidad finished very fast indeed.
Yes, it was a great shame that the South Africans went down. I hope we get some shots of that, because I certainly was, my eye was on the team at the front, and I'm not sure what happened, but Jack Green there, the hurdler. Let's have a look. Oh, this is the final stages, I think. Yes, it is, with Rooney running. It's right at the end. It happened way before this.
This is a fine run there, of course, by the Trinidad man, Dion Lindor, to come through and take second place. Doesn't matter, of course, the first three going through. And of course, we have the sight of the Blade Runner Oscar Pistorius standing forlornly at the third takeover, and he didn't get to run.
No, it's a great shame he didn't. He ran in the heats of the World Championships last year, and then they didn't play, they didn't run him in the final, which he was very disappointed, and he's missed out again here, which is a great shame. But Rooney easing down as Lindor comes through, and the Cuban Cisneros.
And actually, the Trinidad and Tobago team have been given the win.
Yeah,
that,
they looked
that
as
strong dip by Lindor, 4:00:38.
Yeah, it doesn't matter though, the first three go through. Ah, we might see here what happened. This, you see right at the back, the Kenyan team and the South Africans. Now then, what happened? Oh, the Kenyan tripped and brought the South Africans down. Now, it may be that the South Africans are allowed back in on the basis of nine lanes in the final. They might be able to do that, because quite clearly that could happen, because he was brought down. The Kenyan moved right across in front of him and brought him down. So it may be, but obviously there's a bit of an injury there. So that's interesting. And as we watch now the final stages, and there's the changeover. Another pole hits the deck, but really it is quite a battle. Well, there's the update on the result of the first heat. What an incident-packed first heat. Trinidad and Tobago just given it, both the same time as Great Britain, and Cuba, 3:00:55. They're the three qualifiers by right, but watch the other times. The 3:01:70 and 3:02:86 were the two fastest losers. One more heat to go. Incident-packed, that first one.
And this is the lineup for the second one, and it features the United States of America, who've been dominant in the history of the 4x4. They've won it far more times than anybody else. And they've won the last four World Championships, the last couple of Olympic Games. And they would be the favourites here. But one has to remember that they didn't get a runner in the individual 400 metres final, uniquely in the history of Olympic athletics since they've been competing, apart, of course, in the boycott year. And in fact, Bahamas have possibly got a better team going out there in lane eight. We'll see the rundown of the teams in due course. Dominican Republic, United States, Australia, Venezuela, Japan, Russia, Bahamas, and Jamaica. Jamaica, of course, again with a big tradition. Got third, fourth, and third in the last four World Championships. Finalists in Beijing. Well, we're looking here at Manteo Mitchell opens up for the United States. He will hand over to Joshua Mance and then Tony McQuay and Bryson Nelson. Well, that's a good team, but it's not one to frighten the worst of the world, as we have had with previous US teams that have really dominated this event for so very long. USA have won 16 times in the history of the 4x4s, a couple of silver medals as well. And the next best is in fact Britain's two wins, which shows the US total dominance. But I think it's more open this year, because the Americans are certainly some way below the sort of strength that we usually associate with them. Could be they'll bring a couple of reserves in for the final. Teams are allowed to run up to six runners over the two races, the heats and the final. So in other words, you can replace two, or up to two, of the runners who contest a heat. So there's the Bahamas. They'll be led off by Ramon Miller. And they've got two individual finalists, because they've then got Demetrius Pinder, who's a finalist in the 400, then Michael Mathieu, who's unfortunately been disqualified in full start in the 200 metres, and then Chris Brown, who once again was fourth in the individual final. So that's probably the best team on paper. Bahamas out in lane eight. Jamaica are always strong. Again, they're not at their peak though this time. Harriet, Hilton, Gonzalez and Nolan. So on the inside here, Australia. Now they lead off with their best runner, young Steve Solomon, still a junior. Brilliant series of runs here. Smashed his personal best in both heat and semi-final to make the individual final. And they've got authorised Cole and Stephenson. Venezuela, Ramirez, Aguilar, Bravo and Melendez. And Japan, Takase, Kanemaru, Azuma and Nakano. Outside them, a useful squad for Russia. Maxim Dildin, Denis Alexeyev, Vladimir Krasnov and Pavel Tanukin. Very big stars, but all very useful 45-second runners. And this is the Bahamas team I was talking about before. Ramon Miller, Demetrius Pinder, Michael Mathieu and Chris Brown. Very, very strong team. Second twice in the World Championships in 2005-2007. Jamaica, Hyatt, Hilton, Gonzalez and Nolan. Of course, on the inside, the Dominican Republic team, two outstanding stars in that, with Felix Sanchez, the hurdles winner, and anchored by Lueguilin Santos, the junior, who took the silver medal. So Dominican Republic, United States, Australia, Venezuela, Japan, Russia, Bahamas and Jamaica. So off for the United States of America, we have Manteo Mitchell, and then way out on the outside, Ramon Miller going well for Bahamas, with Dane Hyatt for Jamaica outside him. So they're really separated, of course. Cuesta running for Dominican Republic pretty well. Mitchell not going especially well for the United States at this moment, and Ramon Miller of Bahamas looks to be the best, but also Steve Solomon of Australia is having a good run, with Ramirez of Venezuela outside him. But it's the Bahamas team, Ramon Miller, I think they're going to change over. Hyatt of Jamaica, though, is now challenging back for Jamaican champion this year. So Miller will hand over to Pinder, and I think the Bahamas will have a narrow lead. Yes, they do, I think, at that changeover with Jamaica outside. And a strong run by Russia. Dildon had a good leg there. And the US are way back at the moment in seventh place. A poor leg by Mitchell. He's handing over the baton now in the hand of Joshua Mance. He's got a lot of work to do. Coming up on the inside. Out front, Demetrius Pinder, Bahamas. He's flying. Fine runner at both 200 metres and 400 metres this season. Bahamas big lead. United States trying to come all the way around from the back. Dominican Republic having the one and only Felix Sanchez, the 400-meter hurdler, running for them in this leg. Well, he's done a good job as the American. He's come all the way through, but up front, a big lead for the Bahamas. Mathieu now taking over, the US in second place. And then it's a real battle on for that third spot at the moment. All the other six nations all pretty much close together there. So USA have McRae, he's got a lot of work to do to make up, but it's Bahamas now with Mathieu out front. Dominican Republic have Mosier, the Russians in fourth place, they have Krasnov on this leg. The Australians have their best runner on the first leg at first, and it's Cole now for them. But the battle really on at the head of the field now, storming down the front. Dominican Republic and USA, or rather Bahamas and the USA, looking forward to that Dominican Republic. Russia have now come through though into third place. So that's the battle on between them, Dominican Republic, Australia. Jamaicans of course crashed out early on here. Well, they're not likely to get through, let's put it that way, not quite as strong as that. But Bahamas and USA, the two fancied teams. Good strong runs by each of the Bahamas runners. The United States have made up ground since they had a poor run by Mitchell. Tony McRae has run well for them. Didn't make the individual final, but he's doing a good leg here. Mathieu will hand over to Chris Brownlow. This is on the last leg, of course, and Nellon. So those first two almost across the line together, and Russia take that vital third spot. But actually, the time not quite as quick as the first heat, so I think we're going to get fourth and fifth from heat one. But up front, there's a real battle royal between Bahamas and the United States of America, anchored by Chris Brown and US by Bryson Nelson, Nellum, and the Russians taking third place there. Well, both the top two teams broke 3 minutes, so they were quicker than heat one. The times behind them were slower.
Yeah, it's strange to see the United States in that situation. Manteo Mitchell didn't run particularly well at all, did he? And the rest of the team had to really make up. The Venezuela were going well for most. There's where the Jamaicans pulled out. I'm not sure why. There you are. It's not all good for Jamaica.
Well, in fact, just looking back on that race, as we see the angst of the Jamaicans. In fact, the Dominican Republic's time, 3:02.35 in fourth, was good enough to go through. So it, in fact, will be the first four in each of those races who go through. So we'll see Felix Sanchez once again in the final. But the US, of course, yes, Manteo Mitchell didn't run well, but they can replace him in the final. And this is the full-strength Bahamas team. So you'd probably have to say the US were still slight favourites to win yet again. As it was this race, same time, 2:58.87, Bahamas first, USA second, and then Russia, Dominican Republic going through. Now let's just look further back here. Dominican Republic and Russia very much in close contention.
The world junior champion there, making trying to make up some headway in that last leg.
Yeah, the Dominican probably got two top runners, of course, Sanchez and Santos, but perhaps Cuesta and Meji are not quite so strong. Mm. Nonetheless, they're through.
Let's have a look at the changeover. It's a visual changeover, this. Hand out, look for it, put the baton in the hand. Now then. Now here's the Jamaicans. Let's see what happened there. He's got it there. Now, now that was the man, I think, that dropped out. Let's have a look. A lot of vying there. They're all in position as to where their man crossed the 200-meter mark on the far side of the stadium. Look at this. I didn't tell a lot from that.
I think that was the incident there, but there we go. The Bahamas team had an outstanding run by Pinder on the second leg. I think he was only just over 44, I don't know, 44-2, in fact. So that was their outstanding run, but the US came back well. And Jamaica, well, it's not going very well for them. Jermaine Gonzalez is a shadow of the figure that he was.
I think he's injured, and he just stopped.
And we saw him not running well in the individual 400, and I think they took a chance on running him.
Yeah, because he was right in the middle of a straightaway and just stopped.
So there is the result of the second race of the 4x4. Bahamas, United States, Russia, and Venezuela go through. Dominican Republic have been disqualified.
Now, it could be at the changeover. Now, what happens, the point I was making is that you're in that position to take the baton with respect to what happens at the 200-meter mark over on the far side, dead opposite. You've got to go into the inside lane if you're first past that 200 mark, and so on.
And the officials will help position you, but if you change positions, which I think they did, then you can be disqualified.
Yep, absolutely right. Now, there are the teams for the final.